a powerful explosion in the centre of Kabul. A car bomb was used to target the home of the defence minister, who made a video statement tonight to reassure Afghans he was unhurt and that such attacks would not stop him protecting their homeland. The bombing comes as Taliban insurgents step up their offensive, just as the last US and NATO soldiers leave.
As we see, things are getting worse and worse more than ever. I'm worried if I die, so what will happen to my family?
Zarifa Ghaffari is an official in Afghanistan's defense ministry. The Taliban have tried to assassinate her 3 times. Last November, they succeeded in killing her father, who was a general in the Afghan army. She's angry with the Americans, whose betrayal began, she says, when they started negotiating with the enemy.
Why I have to make deal with my killers? Why I have to make deal with the people who killed my dad? The war have been started by US, but now they are leaving us burning in this war and just protecting themselves and their soldiers.
The sound of the Taliban's offensive on Afghanistan's provincial capitals can be heard on the streets of Lashkar Gah, a city which for so long was the British military's HQ in Helmand. These Afghan government forces are preparing for hard fighting. Local people have been urged to leave. If even one Taliban fighter comes to Lashkar Gah city, he will die, says this Afghan army commander. If 1,000 come, he says, 1,000 will die. Brave talk in a place where local officials say the Taliban are already in control of most of the city's districts.
My grave concern is particularly if a political settlement is not in light and things descend into further chaos and we go into a civil war, then not only I would feel unsafe, but I would feel for my survival.
The Afghan Air Force has released imagery of their defence of another provincial capital, Kandahar, where they say a missile strike killed dozens of Taliban fighters. But it is the insurgents' offensive which is gaining momentum. America was the Afghan army's trainer, supplier and biggest ally, but now it is leaving and the Afghan government's strength is ebbing away. Geraint Vincent, News at 10.